Students, in this this is the second class. We are continuing chapter 1, and there first we will discuss systematics. And remember, this systematics comes under, like, when we were teaching biodiversity, that is under biodiversity, as actually biodiversity is not limited to the existing life forms, and we used to continue the explore new areas, and even old ones, new organisms are continuously being added. So here, this entire chapter is actually what we explore. What are the living organisms outside? There are millions and millions of living organisms up there. But overall, one idea we are getting from this chapter. So before reading systematics, there is one word, that is biodiversity. What is that? Biodiversity. And this biodiversity is what biological diversity means, the entire number and types of organism present on this earth. Isn't it? It includes living organism, it includes microorganisms, it includes plants, human beings, everything. It is included. So biodiversity is not limited to the existing life forms. Okay, as I said, we are like 1.7 to 1.8 million number of organisms are there according to this. Now, what is systematics under this biodiversity? This systematic word derived from Latin word. It is called systema, which means systematic arrangement of organism, and Linnaeus, Carolus Linnaeus, is a scientist, and we say he is a taxonomist, and he actually coined this term systematics in 1751, and his book Systema Naturae, here it is written about the systematics. So what is his book? Systema Naturae, and this is the book, and who is the scientist? Carolus Linnaeus. And yes, the Carolus Linnaeus is actually the father of taxonomy. Okay, now he is the person, was the person who has started everything, like how we study living organism, types of living organisms surrounding us. Okay, 1961, Simpson defined systematic as the study of biodiversity of organism and the comparative and evolutionary relationship based on comparative anatomy, physiology, biochemistry and ecology. So when we study on organism, organism ko kaise study kiya jaye, kaun kaun se aspect is organism mein study kiya jaye? Yes, organisms ka comparative and evolutionary relationship study karenge, comparative anatomy study karenge, physiology study karenge, biochemistry study karenge and ecology study karenge. Now I will tell you all these terms afterwards, like what is physiology means, what does ecology means. So lots of terms of there which you have to clear before we go in detail of study of biology. So systematic includes what? What are the components of systematics? So here it is the first identification. This is the first component, identification. Then classification. Okay. And then classification, and after that nomenclature. So these are the components of systematics: identification, classification and nomenclature. Now what is identification? It aims at finding the correct name and appropriate position of an organism. The morphological and anatomical characters are examined after proper identification. Second, classification. Huge number and variety of living organisms make it difficult to study them. So that arise like classification of the entire living organism into some categories we divide. Like when you go to a shop, a shopkeeper used to keep the things as per the similarities, isn't it? As per the function. If you are going to get a soap, that means all soaps are together. You have seen in a rack, all soaps are kept, or different types of different branded soaps are kept. So similarly, if you go for oil, then all oils are kept in one. So that it is very easy to get, and it very easy to know also what is the nature of that kind of object. So here also, if we classify, if we categorize the things, then we can also know that what is the characteristics of that kind of organisms which are related. Okay, but earlier when they do classification, they do in a very superficial way. You know, all organisms who live in water are called aquatic animals. But do you think right now that the animals who are living in water, do they have same characteristics? Dolphin is a mammal, shark is a fish, but all are living in one, that is in sea, ocean, but they have the differences. But if you say in one category they are all fish, we say dolphin is also a fish, shark is also a fish, but they are not fish. One is a mammal and one is going to pieces from. So there are lots of differences are there. So that is what the classification is. But nowadays the classification is very, very elaborate, and lots of characteristics are focused. So it is now in a depth. You can say study is in depth, and after that they have done this classification. So advantages of classification is what? It helps to identify and study of an organism. New organisms easily get correct place. It makes study of fossils also easy. It also helps in building evolutionary pathways. It becomes easy to know the features of whole group by studying one or more two organisms of the group. So classification helps us. Evolution relationship means what? The relationship that existed in between the organism who existed in the past and today. What is the relationship between these two? Now the nomenclature. Now what is this nomenclature? Yes, there's a study in brief. This one nomenclature. It is a naming of an organism. Now the question is what? Why do we need naming? क्यों एनिमल्स एनिमल्स रहता क्यों फिर इसका नेमिंग किया गया कि ह्यूमन बींग का होमोसेपियंस फिर मैंगो का मैंगीफेरा इंडिका सो दिस टाइप ऑफ नेमिंग व्हाई दे नीड नाउ दिस नेम्स आर ऑल साइंटिफिक नेम्स बेस्ड ऑन द लैटिन वर्ड एंड यू नो दैट कॉमन नेम्स आर डिफरेंट कॉमन नेम में तो हमारे इंडिया में कितने सारे लैंग्वेजेस हैं सो इफ यू यूज एवरीबडी यूज देयर लैंग्वेज देन दिस लैंग्वेज इन अ वर्ड मीनिंग इज डिफरेंट इन ऑल केसेस इजंट इट मीनिंग इज डिफरेंट So in Odia it is said Moni so and then Admi, but all refers to human being. So rather you give one name which can be understood by total world. That is Homo sapiens. If I am telling that I am talking about Homo sapiens, everybody will understand. But if I say I am talking about Moni so, then may not be understood by the other parts of the world, right? So variety of names will create chaos, confusion. To avoid that, scientific names are implemented. So this advantage of common name is there. All the organisms cannot be named by this method because alag-alag meaning ho jata hai. An organism may have several names as per the language. That is also a chaotic situation. It will create different meanings in the world. It may create. So one common name may have different meanings in the different country. Like maize means wheat, but other grains in the USA, but it is called corn in some countries. So different meanings may appear. Now this nomenclature can be your binomial nomenclature. Now binomial means what? Two name given. Like a two name means as I write one example in this is Homo, and then it will start with the small letter, and that is sapiens. So this is the man, the name of the man, Homo sapiens. So there is a particular name. How to write is Homo is H is with capital letter and S will be the small letter. Right? So this is Homo sapiens and how we write this is genus and this is species name. So two naming system is there by the naming. Now this is given by whom? Same Carolus Linnaeus in 1751 in his book Philosophia Botanica. So all scientific names of animals under binomial nomenclature given by Linnaeus in Systema Naturae book. And also there why he has written one more book is Species Plantarum. So what is the another book he has written? That is Species Plantarum. Species Plantarum. So the books written by Carolus Linnaeus are very important. So this is generic epithet, this is specific epithet. Even scientific name of mango is also written like Mangifera indica. Okay, Mangifera represents the genus. And next one is referring this. Now this binomial nomenclature, and there are two institutions that are presently working, ICBN and ICZN. Okay, international, this is botanical nomenclature and international code for botanical nomenclature 1961, and ICZN and international code for zoological nomenclature. Similarly, ICBN one more bacteriological nomenclature and one more is viral nomenclature. So these nomenclatures function, organization function is to name the organism. Okay, name the organism. And sometimes when you write this, there must sometimes it is written like the name of the genus and species, and then at the last it is written like this LINN, Linn. And Linn means what? Linnaeus has found that. So to give respect, like Mangifera indica Linn. Now Linn refers to Linnaeus. Okay, so similarly, and this is binomial fine. Advantages of binomial nomenclatures are many. And now the next thing is that. What is taxonomy? Okay, what is that? What is taxonomy? What is taxonomy?
it is the science of identification, classification, and nomenclature. Based on their spatial characteristics, the living organisms can be classified into different categories. So the scientific term for these categories is taxa. So
it's a taxonomy look at. So kaise ek categorization ko kaise likhte hain, this is based on the label called taxon.
And father of taxonomy, already I said, Carolus Linnaeus.
So who is the father of taxonomy? He is the person whom already I said, that is Carolus Linnaeus.
And what is taxonomic categories? Now, category classification is not a single step process, it is a hierarchy of steps. Okay, so taxon is that unit of classification. In fact, it represents a rank and it's commonly nicknamed as taxon. So if I write taxonomic hierarchy, you can understand what is this.
So what is the taxonomic hierarchy? So what is this hierarchy? It starts from, like for plants and animals, it differs. Both almost same, little bit difference is there. Plants and animals, it differs. In animals, the first, like you will get the largest one is kingdom. Okay, and then you will get after that phylum. And then you will get class. Then you will get order. Then you will get family. Now these are, each one is a taxon. And then you will get genus after the family, and then you will get their species. But in plants, this phylum is known as division. That's only the differences. Rest all are same.
So for animals, kingdom, but the large kingdom kya hota? What is kingdom? It's the largest category. This is a category. But category and taxon may be different. A taxon deals with the real biological objects, but a category is an abstract term. Okay. So if I write now, I will say you how to do this. Like category is what? Kingdom. The kingdom is called category. But if I write the taxon. Okay. If I write this taxon, intermediate categories and obligate categories are also there under the taxon categories. So this is a taxon and category. Taxon deals with the real biological objects. Okay, the taxon of human is mammalia. Suppose mammalia. So mammalia is the kingdom is the animalia, but phylum is the mammalia. So this is a taxon. But if I write now, this is what mammalia. Now this is what we say taxon. So taxon deals with the real biological objects, but category is an abstract term. Okay, that is the unit of classification. So these are category. But if I write the phylum of human being is mammalia, now mammalia is a taxon. Clear? Is it okay? So mammalia is a class. It's not a phylum. It is a class. Phylum means class. Okay. Chal. So this is taxon and category. We have understood. So let us now complete the definition of each one. Like what is kingdom? Kingdom is a large, an animal kingdom. Kingdom animalia means it includes all the animals who are heterotrophs, obviously, and autotrophs are different. Phylum, then next one you will get phylum, which is little small. Next one you will get class, then it is little small. Like kingdom is animalia, then phylum what we will get? Like vertebrates and invertebrates, these two categories are who are having bones and who are not having bones. Similarly, class mammalia, that means those are mammals. Under mammals, again primates and non-primates. So after that, family is also there. Like chimpanzee, human beings, these are all one type. Like, and if it say dogs, then cats, they are of another type. So again, your family differs, right? Order differs. Then in family also, like you come cat family. Cat family means including all tiger, cat, puma, wild cat, domestic cat, all types of cats will come under cat family. And then again, cat family may be sabka genus alag bhi ho sakta, kisi ka same bhi ho sakta. Now species name is totally unique. Species name is totally unique. Species may ekdam totally difference. Total difference. So species is what? Is a population which? Species is what? Which is a population of similar individuals. Okay, similar individuals. Species is a population of organisms having similarity in all aspects, and they reproduce among themselves. They breed among themselves. But genus may not breed. Like a lion is also a cat family and tiger is also a cat family. But lion and tiger never reproduce because the genus is maybe same because of some characteristics, but species is totally different. Okay, so these are the different taxons are there, and I think the first chapter is almost complete. Join the online class for the doubt clearing, and we can discuss many aspects over there also in detail. Read NCRT and ask me your doubts in the online class. Thank you.